For over a decade, we've been doing a big study called the Top Projects, where we analyze all of the largest new oil and gas developments in the industry. And each year, the number of projects tended to go up as we discovered new development areas, as new technologies opened up new basins. Interestingly, this time, for the first time, we have reduced the amount of projects from 420 to 400. And the key reason for that is that some of these projects have become so uneconomic, so stranded, that we almost don't see any scenario under which they would be developed. And it's all part of these new industry dynamics, what we call the new oil order. If we look back for a moment to how the oil industry used to work, there used to be one swing producer that was OPEC, that had effectively pricing power, and then there was non-OPEC, which would develop these projects on a 5-6 years lead time with almost 10 years for the payback. And then shale oil appeared and completely changed the industry dynamic. So shale oil is the first swing producer in non-OPEC with very short lead time, less than 1 year, with quick payback time, a year and a half, and with enormous resources. When we look at competitiveness on a country-by-country basis, there are some countries where we think the projects are completely stranded because they don't give good returns, and those are effectively Australia and Canada. Then there are some countries which are today uneconomic because of the very high tax rate. This is, for instance, Angola, it's Nigeria. And then there are those countries that actually have improved their competitiveness, largely because shale resources have been discovered and are economic, the US, as everybody knows, but also Argentina. And to some extent, new regions that have opened up with big new discoveries like Mozambique. So in this environment, if we think about the key companies, the key producers in oil and gas, there's no doubt that the focus has to be on efficiency. Efficiency in production, efficiency in the use of capital, cost cutting. There probably will be some M&A in order to improve the position in the cost curve and move lower. And if we put this all together, it's pretty clear that the focus is going to be on returns and on cash preservation for the industry.